everybody, Christina Hoffmeyer here with the RE/MAX Select Realty Christina Hoffmeyer team. I know that you usually catch me in houses, and we're showing you our latest projects, brand new listings, you know, construction before and afters, talking about investment deals. But today you're finding me in my home office, sitting at my desk, which is very messy right now, by the way, so I apologize for that. But we're having a lot of virtual appointments right now. Consumers are liking those more and more with the COVID numbers that are currently elevated in the county surrounding where I am. So I just thought I'd just take a minute just to check in with all of you and to give you an update on the state of the market. I have been flooded with calls, emails, messages on Facebook and Instagram asking me how is the market and how is COVID playing a role within the market. So just to reach out to all of you all at once in this short and sweet video to kind of give you the idea of what's going on in the market, how things are affecting buyers and sellers, and why they're affecting buyers and sellers so much. So if you ask any real estate agent, we're all trained to say exactly the same response when asked, how's the market? Very first thing that we're taught after we get out of real estate school is to say, the market's fantastic, regardless of whether it is or not. So I can tell you from my own personal experience doing this as long as I have, the market is always fantastic, just depending on which side of the fence you're on. It's different for a buyer and it's different for a seller and it's different depending on the condition of the market. So sometimes it's a buyer's market, sometimes it's a seller's market, sometimes it's a neutral market where it's equally beneficial for both. Right now, the market is a strong seller's market. And what does that mean? It means that right now, sellers have the upper hand advantage over the buyers because of supply and demand. Supply and demand plays a crucial role in all retail sales, not just real estate. And if you've ever sold anything or been in any type of retail setting, you'll know that the more of something there is, the less the price tends to be, where if something is in high demand and low inventory, then the price tends to go up. Let's think about it in the climate that we're in right now with COVID. Every time there is a spike in COVID numbers, everybody runs out and buys toilet paper. And then ridiculous sellers online start marking up toilet paper for 10 times the cost because everybody needs toilet paper, but nobody can find anything. It works the same way with real estate in a nutshell. So right now with the climate of the market, based on a couple of different factors, there are very few listings, very few sellers in the market, but a huge number of buyers in the market right now. So demand is high, supply is low, which is driving up the cost of real estate, both listings and with rentals. So whether this makes you happy or sad, angry or glad, it's all what it is. If you're a seller within the market, you're able to sell your home rather quickly and for an increased price over what you could have last year. But if you're a buyer, even though the interest rates are low, you're having trouble finding a house and you're competing with other buyers tooth and nail to get the home of your dreams. So again, the market all depends on who you are and why you're asking. So if you're a seller, congratulations, you're in a great seller's market. And if you're a buyer, it's still a great time to buy, but just don't get discouraged. All right, so another question I get asked is, what is causing this extreme seller market? It just hit us like a ton of bricks out of nowhere. And you're right. And depending on who you ask, it could be one reason, it could be multiple reasons, but these are the most common, and I'm not being biased. These are just what the experts are saying. There's a few reasons why we have the kind of market that we have right now. One of those is the COVID pandemic. If you remember, the state of Pennsylvania was shut down for quite some time, and us realtors couldn't even work. We couldn't show houses. So we have what's called pent-up demand of buyers. This means that there's a bunch of buyers from the spring that wanted to buy that still haven't bought because they either couldn't get out and look or there's not enough listings to satisfy those buyers. But just as the market works, day by day, week by week, more and more and more and more buyers enter that market. So it's building and building and building and building and building. That's called pent-up demand. Think of it this way. Let's say you're driving into the city and it's rush hour traffic. It's two or three lanes and the traffic is already bumper to bumper. Then you get to an off-ramp and you have a ton of cars trying to enter that roadway at the same time that the cars that are already approaching are trying to get through. This causes a bottleneck and it causes the traffic jam to even be worse. This is currently what we're experiencing with buyers. We have the buyers who were already came in the spring trying to buy, who were unable, trying to get through that road towards their home, while we have new buyers coming off the off-ramp and trying to shuffle their way in between the buyers that are already there. This is why we have the pent-up demand. It works the same way. Reason number two why experts say we have a lot of buyers and not enough sellers: our interest rates are historically low. And if you've been following real estate for any period of time, you've been hearing this over and over for the last couple years. What I want you to do is think back to the 80s and 90s, if you're old enough to remember that. I remember as a little girl, my parents getting their first mortgage and paying 12.5% on their mortgage and thinking that was a steal. Back in parts of the 80s and 90s, it wasn't unheard of to get an interest rate from 11% to the whole way up to 16%. So them getting a mortgage for 12.5% was an absolute steal to them. I mean, can you imagine if you walked into a bank in today's climate and said, "I'd like to purchase a home," and they said, "Sure, we'll do that for 12.5%. You would be floored. With the interest rates at 2 and 3%, it is unheard of interest rates. So because of that, the homes become more affordable. We have programs that are offering little to no money down on houses. And this is allowing buyers who traditionally couldn't buy back in the 80s and 90s because they couldn't afford it, they're now able to buy. We have a lot of even the older generation now purchasing their very first home because the interest rates are so low and there's so many government-sponsored programs out there to help. This is also allowing the younger generation to buy at younger and younger age because housing is so affordable. This overall brings more and more buyers into the marketplace that we didn't have in the years past, adding even further to that pent-up demand. Okay, reason number three why the market is in the state that it's in. And this one has to do with the sellers. This is actually a two-parter. So it's basically, experts say that sellers just have an unsure climate of what the future holds. And that is for, I'm sure, a multitude of reasons, but what you hear talked about the most is the COVID pandemic and politics. I'm not gonna cover either one in full detail, but those are two of the reasons why sellers are not comfortable putting their homes on the market right now. Now, COVID is pretty clear. It's a huge concern right now. Our numbers are through the roof locally. People are scared of getting sick. They're scared of losing their jobs, and that's all valid reasons. So sellers are not as likely to put their homes on the market if they have an unsure climate of what's going to happen next. The second of those is politics. Whether you're on one side or the other, it doesn't matter. You've seen the news, you've read it on social media. People are fighting, media is out of control. We don't know what the state of our government is going to be, and that also causes sellers to be unsure or unconfident to put their homes on the market. So again, we have a ton of buyers and not enough sellers. So what does that mean for the buyers that are currently in the market and the sellers who are currently in the market? All right, let's cover buyers first. Now, the buyers that are currently in the market, my advice to you is to go into this with your eyes wide open. Be patient. You may not find the home that you're looking for in the first week or the first trip with your agent. You may find a home that you love and not be able to get it because of multiple offer situations or that the home accepted an offer before you could get out to see it. This is just the state of things that we're in. So what I can tell to you is keep an open line of communication open with your real estate agent. Be truthful and honest of what you want. Don't settle for something just to buy something. Be patient and have a backup plan. Make sure that if you're renting, you can extend your lease just in case you need to, or find a plan B for other housing, maybe staying with a family member and friend if that's something that's available to you. But definitely be patient and don't buy something just to buy something, because we see buyers over and over again just wanting to buy anything because they feel like it's going to get away. Don't let that get the best of you. And please speak to your agent about what's important to you so that agent can remind you whether the home you're looking at really truly suits your needs. And sellers, what does this mean for you? When you put your home on the market, understand that your home may sell quickly. So knowing that in advance and knowing that you will have to act fast and move fast is imperative. Make sure that you already have some type of vision of where you're going to next, and make sure that you voice that to your agent so he or she knows what the next step will be. If you have any time restrictions on your move, please, please, please say those in advance. Let your agent know that you can't move until such and such a date for whatever reason. Make sure that your agent understands how you want the home sale to go. That's important. Your home may sell quicker than you thought. Also, in the current climate conditions, we're finding that a lot of sellers are trying to do a lot on their own. And we do suggest that you always work with a trusted professional, whether that's a real estate agent or an attorney. With things being what they are, people are at high stress and at high anxiety. It's important to have everything in writing. So make sure you're working with somebody who does this day out, day in and day out, and can protect your interest. For those of you sellers who are looking to enter the market and are unsure whether or not to list your home, I've said this three times already in this session, but talk to your agent. What we like to do, or what I like to do, is to make sure that the seller knows exactly what they're going to do after the home sells, before we list the home. This is important. So if you have any concerns, whether it be about politics or COVID or moving or family or whatever that may be, make sure you're talking to your agent and voice those concerns before you put the home on the market. It is a great time to list and sell your home, people. It's a great time, but only if it's right for you. So if you are looking to get that home sold for more money than you could have last year because prices are up, make sure you give us a call and we would be happy to help you, walk you through the process, give you a free, no obligation consultation on exactly what your home is worth, and then it's up to you what you do from there. But I can tell you that we need your listings on the market right now. So if you are thinking of selling, regardless of the location, regardless of the price, regardless of the condition, give us a call and we'll come over, we'll speak with you and see if listing your home right now is the best choice for you and your family. So this is all I have for you in this session. I didn't want to make it too long, but if you have any questions about what's going on in our current real estate market, please feel free to give us a call anytime. We'd be happy to answer any questions that you would have. And I'm going to enjoy the rest of my afternoon here at my house. I don't get to do it too often, but I have my puppies sleeping here beside me. If you know me or follow us on Facebook, you know that, you know, I'm a huge dog person, so I'm going to spend a little time with them, spend a little time with my son this afternoon while I have a little bit of a break. But if you need me, call me. And until next time, see you soon.